I did something stupid, you know. I mean, it spoils you playing with Ringo because you get treated very well, you know. I went straight from Ringo's tour to my own tour, which was a bit silly. You know, because 20 minutes after you finished playing Ringo's show, you're in a Gulfstream 4 at 45,000 feet with a woman saying, "Would you like a lobster sandwich, Mr. Hay?" And Ringo sitting opposite you going, "All right, Carl. Not bad, eh? Peace, brother." "You're not bad, it's right, boss." You know, it's a very, very nice way to travel. And then I went straight, I dovetailed my own tour, so I went straight from Ringo's tour to my own tour, so I found myself in St. Louis filling up the minivan with gas. You know? And the band that are sleeping in the minivan, and I'm thinking, there's something wrong here. It's quite sad. And I went in to pay the woman for the gas. I think she was a woman. It's tricky sometimes, you know. She said, "You have a nice accent. Where are you from?" And I said, "Well, originally I'm from Scotland." She said, "Scotland? Wow. What are you doing here?" I said, "Oh, I live here." She said, "Do you live in America?" I said, "Yeah." She said, "Oh, I don't like it here." I said, "Really?" She said, "No, I don't like it here." I said, "Well, if you could live anywhere, where would you live?" She said, "Probably the land down under." I said, "Really?" She said, "Yeah, probably the land down under." And I said, "You know, I wrote that song." She said, "What?" I said, "I wrote that song." She said, "You did not." I said, "Yeah." Then she said, "You did not." And just then my bleary-eyed tour manager walked in from the van. And I said, "Hey, Jeff, what do you think is the most popular song that I've ever written?" And he said, "Oh, I don't know." So he was no help at all. And she said, "Anyway, I know you didn't write that song because you don't remind me at all of Sting."